Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing well. I'm Shubham and you are watching Let's Create an App. So this is part 4th of Auto Layouts and Constraints video series. So in previous 3 videos, we have covered this UI. So basically this is in part 1, we are using multipliers to create these things. And in part 2, we have created a sign up screen. And in part 3, we have created a sign in screen. So in this part, we are going to cover how we can create a tab bar, something like this. As well as I've already having a video on tab bar on my channel. You can go and watch that video also. The link of the video was mentioned in the description as well as on the I button. And in that video, I've just created a custom class for a tab bar because I have changed the background color of the selected tab. So that is something really different from this tab bar. So if you want to learn that thing also, you can go and watch that video also. And apart from that, we are going to change the route whenever a user logged in the application. For example, if a user log in application and he terminates the app and come back to the application, then he will move on the dashboard, not on the login screen. So this is the way how we can change the route whenever user log in the application. So we are going to cover these topics in this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment box. And if you are new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other video. So let's start the video. Let's create an app. So now let's move on the Xcode. And we have left the previous video over here. So if you don't know what we have done till yet, please go and watch the previous videos. Now we have to take one tab bar over here. So simply write tab bar, tab, and we have to select this tab bar controller. So just drag and drop tab bar controller over here, something like this. Now let's move this thing a little bit down. Now we have to take 2 more controllers because on the screen which we are going to create, we are having a 4 tab bars: home, views, explain and profile. So we have to take 2 more controllers over here. So just drag and drop 2 more controllers. So simply write view controller, or that's the first thing which we have seen over here. So now let's drag and drop 1 more controller, and that is also view controller type, something like this. So we have take 4 controllers. Now we have to add 2 more controllers on this tab bar. So just press control and drag and drop on the controllers which are not connected. Now just click on this relationship segue and just click on this view controller. So it will automatically create or connect this tab bar with this controller. Now just do the same thing one more time with the 4th controller, and this is done. Now we have to change the images as well as the name of the view controllers. So simply just change the name to over here, just like home. Now we have to assign the images to this tab bar. So for that we have to first import the images. So just move on the asset side, asset folder. Now let's take the images which are on the desktop. These ones, I've already downloaded these images from the internet. Now just drag and drop over here. Maybe these images are not in the proper size because I have downloaded, but whenever you are trying to create a demo thing, then it is fine. But when you create these thing in a projects, then definitely there is some designer that they will provide you a better icons, something like that. So now let's move to the storyboard again and just assign the images which you want as a home. So on home, I want this home icon, which is normal icon, and the selected images, home selected. So I've just given a names to these images, something like that. Whatever is selected, it is written as selected. So this is a very easy way to identify that which image is selecting. Now just move on the second item, and the second item is like, I guess the second item is use, and just simply write use, and the image is like, I think, briefcase, and the selected image is briefcase selected, and the third one is like explore, yeah, correct, explore, and the image is like search, I guess search, that's the search one, and the selected image is like search selected, and the last one is profile. The image for this is profile user icon, and selected user, I guess, yeah, user selected icon. So our tab bar is ready. Yeah, it's really very simple to create a tab bar. But yeah, for managing this tab bar, it's very difficult. So we are going to see how we can manage this tab bar. So now let's run this thing and check that it is working fine or not. So before running this thing, let's make this tab bar as a root controller, so that we are not going to write any code to move on this tab bar. We are going to do that thing in some other time. So the image is not coming for this profile. Okay, yeah, I guess we have assigned a different image for this thing. So just change this image for profile thing, and that is not a user icon, that is user symbol, this one. Yeah, so now I think this is fine. Yeah, so now let's check this thing again that it is working fine or not. So this is very easy thing to create a tab bar. So completely tab bar is working fine. We have created a tab bar, all the selections are working completely fine. So this is very easy. But if we are having more things, like just like on the first screen, we have to move on the next screen. So that we need a navigation controller, and there we cannot place any kind of navigation controller behind this tab bar. So we need to put the navigation controllers on every child of this tab bar. So just click on this editor, click on embed it and put on navigation controller, something like this. So with every child, we have to put one navigation controller, so that it will help to move on the next controllers. Simply like this. We can do a navigation controller from both the sides, from editor as well as from this below over here. This is an update with Xcode 10.1. So this is done. So now let's run again and check that it is working fine or not. Then we will going to write the code for changing the roots, how we can change the roots. So simply we are working fine, and we have get a navigation bar over the top. So definitely we have a functionality something like that. On the some tabs we want a navigation bar, on some tabs we don't want navigation bar at the top. But yeah, the navigation controller will always over there, because we always want moving from one controller to the another controller in every application. So this is a very basic process which we'll follow. Now we have to create a tab bar class, so that we can assign this tab bar class to this tab bar controller. So for that, just move on this over here, click on this controller, just create new file and just create over here. And this should be a subclass of a UI tab bar, and you can give any name for this class. So I'm just giving tab bar, tab bar view controller, something like this. This is good. Now just click on create, and this class is created now. So we don't need to write any kind of coding over here if we don't want to do any kind of customization to this tab bar. If we want to do some kind of customization to this tab bar, we can write all the things over here. So now let's assign this class to this tab bar. Simply select the tab bar and assign a class to this tab bar. Tab bar view controller, something like this, and also give a storyboard with the same name, whatever the name of the class. Now let's talk about the basic problem which we always face whenever we try to log in. So now let's change that root view controller again, but just simply assigning an initial view controller to this navigation controller, and run again this thing and check that how it's working. And also we can do, like, whenever users sign up this thing, just on the click of this button, let's navigate to. So whenever user tap on this button, he will always move. Press control and click on this show. So this will create a segue between these controllers. Now let's run and check that how it's looking. So whenever user tap on this sign in thing, it will automatically move on this tab bar. So just click on this sign in and just click on this sign in. So we have moved on this tab bar thing, but this back button is always there. We need to hide this button, and whenever user terminate this app, then he will automatically redirect it to this first landing page, and that is this one. So we don't want this thing in our application. So for that, we have to create one method, and that method will come various places. For example, if user logged out from the application, or we have to change root multiple times from different places, then we will make a method which is available for all the view controllers. So just create an extension, just click on new file and just select a Swift file over here, and just give the name to UI view controller plus extension all the methods are written related to the UI view controller over here. Just write extension, and it is of UI view controller type. UI view controller. Yeah, it's not coming because UI kit is not implemented over here. UI view controller. Simply like this. Now just create one function over here. Function change root, something like this. So in this first we need to get a view controller on which we have to change the root. So let VC is equals to StoryBoard dot initiate view controller with identification. So the identification is the tabbar controller which we want to move whenever we have to change the root. So simply change this thing like this and paste the thing over here, something like this. And as a tabbar controller, tabbar view controller, something like this. Now we have to create the object of our app delegate. So let app delegate is equals to UI application dot shared dot key window. Delegate as app delegate, something like this. Now we have to get the app delegate dot window dot root view controller is equals to VC, something like this. Now we have to make this thing a visible thing also, dot window dot key visible. I guess this method make key visible, make key invisible, something like this. So we need to call this method whenever user move from login controller to the dashboard. So it will automatically change the route and user will not move going to back on the login controller, or there is no back button because there is no view on the stack before this controller, that dashboard controller. So this is very simple process, but yeah, you can put the checks over here that whatever control is coming is a tabbar controller. You need to typecast this thing also so that application didn't get crashed. There are various other conditions which we need to think of whenever we are going to work on a real-time application. So this is just kind of a demo thing. So now let's save this thing, press Ctrl S, and just move on this login view controller. And we didn't created any kind of button outlets. Yeah, definitely we didn't need that thing. So now let's remove this segue and create an outlet of this sign in button. Just login view controller, and this is sign in button. It's on over here. Just create the action for this sign in button. So on click sign in, and just like this thing. And now we have to call that simple method. So definitely we have to call an API over here, and then in the success of that API we will get some kind of token. So we have to change the route at that moment. So first we need to check that it is working fine or not. So just simply write set root view controller. It's not working. Sorry, the change root. The name of that is change root. This thing. So now let's run this thing and check that it is working fine or not. It will changing a root or not after removing a segue from this controller to this controller. Simply like this. So now let's click on this sign in button. And now let's click on this sign in button. So we have successfully changed the root whenever user click on this sign in button. But there is one problem in this scenario also, that whenever we have terminated the application and run the application again, it will always come on this sign in screen, not on the dashboard. So for that we have to manage this thing by just user default. Whenever user log in something, there is something definitely come from the API, that is an access token, because without access token we can't run the APIs or manage the sessions. So we have to save that access token on the user default. So just save that thing on the user default dot standard dot set value for key. And in this we have to just save access token. I'm saving something just string logged in, and in the string key I'm passing access token, something like this. And we are just copy this thing and let's move on the app delegate. And we have to put a check over here that if there is something in the app delegate, means user has already logged in. So we have to change the route to the dashboard or home controller. So for that, just get the access token request to user default, not user activity, user default dot standard dot value for key, and in this we have to pass the string. So if access token is not equals to nil, means if there is something in the access token, means user have logged in, then we have to move that person on the dashboard, else he can move on the login. So we don't need to put the else part, it will automatically redirect it to the login. Now if there is something in the access token, we have to move that person on the dashboard. So for that we have to just follow, call the change root method. But yet change root method is not available over here because it's not of a UI view controller type. So we have to copy that method which we have written over here. So on this method, yeah, definitely this is a duplicacy of a method, but we have to do, we will find some other way to do this thing, and there is some error, I guess. The storyboard is not available in AppDelegate also, so I guess there is some kind of error. Yeah, so let's create storyboard. Storyboard equals to UI storyboard, and we have to name the storyboard is main, main, and bundle is nil, like this. Now let's copy this or change this question mark only, and I guess this will work fine. Yeah, now let's run again and check that it is working fine or not. I hope everything will work fine, and just put a breakpoint over here. So let's first sign in the user, and as I click on the sign in, now we have logged in the application. Now terminate the application and run again and put the breakpoint over here so that user will move in this block or not. So there's something in the access token, definitely. So we have moved in, and now we have, I guess, landed on the dashboard. So we have successfully achieved this functionality, and this is very easy functionality. So I hope you have learned something from this video, and if yes, please don't forget to hit the like button, and if you're new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. And if you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment box. So this is for today. Thank you.